Access for Everyone, Breaking Down Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities. Topic 19, Reporting and Responding to Digital Barriers for People with Disabilities.
When I can access everything, school is easier.
And we want education for all students to be easy to access. This video is for people with disabilities and school administrators. We want to address avenues for reporting or responding to reports of digital accessibility barriers.
A digital barrier is when you can't access digital content you need to access. Most people experience this when the internet is down, but individuals with disabilities may experience digital barriers regularly. For example, when encountering inaccessible technology that cannot be made accessible immediately.
Meet 8-year-old Kai. Like most 8-year-olds, he's an active boy and loves doing what 8-year-old boys like to do. But unlike most 8-year-olds, Kai is blind. He uses a screen reader, braille display, and other tools in class and for homework. He likes how technology enables him to do the same schoolwork as his classmates, but it can also be challenging. When instructional materials and websites are inaccessible, individuals with disabilities may be denied equal access to educational programs and other services and activities. Kai told us of a situation where there was no alternative text, so his screen reader couldn't tell him what was on the screen. What can he or his parents do then?
As the other videos in this series have addressed, there are lots of ways the educational community can find and remediate barriers or avoid them at the design stage. But we all realize technology is constantly changing. So even those who are really paying attention to accessibility may let something slip through the cracks. And students like Kai, or parents or community members with disabilities, may find themselves in very frustrating situations where they simply do not have equal access to what others enjoy.
So, what can a school do to reduce barriers and frustration and increase accessibility for people with disabilities? First, make sure your website contains clear information on whom to contact if a user with a disability encounters a barrier. Make sure the contact information is in an easy-to-find location on your web pages. And second, establish clear procedures within your organization so that when individuals reach out for help, they get the help that they need. Ensure that you're not asking people to bounce between a disability services office and an IT department, or make them go to your vendor for help. Work together to get them immediate access to the underlying service, program, or activity while you are removing the barrier.
If you are a person with a disability who is personally experiencing a digital barrier and can't access content on a school website, as a first step, ask the school for help or to provide another way to get the content or services you need. But if you don't think your school is providing adequate access, contact OCR for technical assistance or to file a complaint. You also may seek to enforce your rights through the courts. This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ED.gov.